Hey guys, Prussian Blue here. This video I'll be making some hydroiodic acid. This is one of these videos that you're not even sure if you should upload it because some idiots might think that I'm making meth or something. Generally, I advise against making any illegal stuff, obviously, because, well, you'll be caught and you'll most likely fuck something up. Also, to remove any doubts, the hydroiodic acid was destroyed after filming this video and I'm doing this to explore the science behind it. Hydroiodic acid is the strange cousin of his more popular and successful cousin, hydrochloric acid. Hydroiodic acid is colorless, but it's really hard to find one that is, because it readily breaks down into iodine. One of its main uses in industry is the cativa process. In the cativa process, hydroiodic acid serves as a co-catalyst in the production of acetic acid by the carbonylation of methanol. It can also be used as a reducing agent, for example, in the reduction of aromatic nitro compounds to anilines. Hydroiodic acid's anhydrous form is hydrogen iodide, and it's a gas that is produced in the reaction I'll be doing. If you care enough about the perfect yield, you can capture it using some water, although to be honest, it's such a small amount that if you're not doing this at a big scale or something, it doesn't really make sense. However, if you're not some giant company, I've got no idea why would you want to run this at a large scale. For this synthesis, I'll be using 12.5 mL of 75% phosphoric acid and 20 grams of sodium iodide. Because phosphoric acid is a weak acid, it won't oxidize the sodium iodide into elemental iodine right away. That's mainly why phosphoric acid is used. If you use an acid like sulfuric or hydrochloric, it will rip apart the sodium iodide and create elemental iodine. To a 100 meter boiling flask, I've added the reagents, then I've added a distillation joint, then I've added an aniline condenser because I don't have a normal one. At least it's not a fucking gram. By the way, while we're talking about condensers, subscribe. This is still a better segue than what dreams us, right? Moving on, I've put my hot plate setting to the max and I waited for it to react. As the mixture was heated, the flask became red because the hydroiodic acid was already falling apart into iodine, but that's to be expected. After a while, the yellow iodine color became even more apparent in the flask and the liquid got even darker. Here are some of the first drops of our distillate. After all, we can see a black oily substance in our collection flask. This is the final yield of hydroiodic acid and we've got around 4 mils. Before we get into the experiments, I just wanted to mention how fun it is to me that the only tutorial for hydroiodic acid on YouTube is on a channel called Walter White. For this experiment, I'll be testing if aluminum foil reacts with the acid. When using hydrochloric acid, the acid starts ripping it apart, but I was curious if the hydroiodic acid would act the same. The acid was poured into the beaker and then I've added some aluminum foil. I was ready for it to start shredding into pieces, but then was severely disappointed. Obviously, the hydrochloric acid in most uses is concentrated and the hydroiodic acid's performance could be due to it being quite dilute. However, even the dilute hydrochloric acid at least reacts with the aluminum. So that's all I've got, thanks for watching, if you like this video make sure to subscribe. By the way, I'll be working with some uranium, in fact I've already had it delivered to me. If you want, you can give me some cool ideas what I should do with it.